Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video on Nanocad. Nanocad with the free version of Nanocad. And in this video, we are going to create an introduction of this software. If you like this video, subscribe to this YouTube channel. First link on the description, the complete course Nanocad 5, these free versions, is available. So if you want to learn everything about this software step by step with a course structure, complete course, this course will be perfect. It is on the first link on the descriptions. You will see the models, the sessions, and everything that you can learn. Second link on the description, you will see the website in link with these channels. In these channels, you have video tutorials or different graphic design software, a lot of open source and free software. And on this website, you will see a summary of all the courses. So this is the versions of Nanocad. It is Nanocad 5. Nanocad 5 is just the free versions. You only work with 2D drawing. It's not possible to work with 3D drawing. It is only 2D drawing. It's not an updating version, so it means it is an older version, but extremely convenient to work with CAD. And it is totally free. So first things to do, but his introduction is to see the dashboard. So you can find different type of workbench on the top, just here. And after to find these different workbenches, you will have the possibility to have also different type of tools on this area. So on the left, you have all the drawing tools, extremely important, all the drawing tools. Don't forget that inside you can have also other type of tool. You just need to stay left click. And if you go on the right, you can find all the transformation tools. So here it is the drawing tools and transformation tools. At the same time, in the center, you can have your space of work. And if you want to have a grid, you can just activate grid options here. And you can also activate snap to grid. You will have the possibility to edit the grid with right click, and you have setup. And thanks to that, you can edit your grid if you need. And about the snapping option, when you go right click, setup, you have also the snapping option for the grid, but you have also OSnap. It is all the snapping options. And when, for example, you don't use the grid, you can select different type of snapping options. So after that, after to understand these parameters, you can also find again the basic things like create a new document, save and export. You can have undo, redo panels. You can zoom in, zoom out. And here on this area, something extremely important, you have layer panels. So this is a layer panels. And after that, when you click here, you can open this layer panels. We have a layer by default, and we can create new layers. So if you want to zoom in, zoom out, I'm going to show you after. The first things to do is to click on one of these drawing tools and to create something. For example, if I want to create a rectangle, I can select my rectangle tool. I can start from the center or on another part, and I will be able to create a rectangle. Don't forget that when you go on the options, so it means when you go here, this is a format first. I forgot to tell you something. It is first when you go on tools, you have a setting parameter, so you can edit the parameters just here. And you have also some options. So setting parameters here, if you need. And you have also tools, and you can find also some options on this area. And for example, if you just click on color settings, you have a backgrounds, and my backgrounds is in white for the simple reason that I changed the backgrounds in white. So you need to go on options, you need to select backgrounds, and thanks to that, you can double click and you can select the color that you want. So I can double click here and change the color. And you can select the white if you prefer. Personally, I prefer to work with the white backgrounds. You can also edit some color for other things, but the most important things for me, it is this one. If you just come back on format, you can also change the unit, drawing unit. Here I'm working in decimal. And format, you have drawing units here. Let's just press escape. So the first things to do, let's create, for example, a rectangle. And you can define a first point. You can use, for example, your grid. And you can create something. I can create my first rectangle, maybe just like this. After that, if I want to create a line, I can also use my line tools, create a line, draw a line, just like this. And you have different tools that you can use on this area. If I want to add a circle, I can add a circle, but you have multiple options. You can use these circle tools and, for example, create a first circle here. And I can use my circle tools and create another circles, for example, just on this area, smaller. So each time when you have element, depending of what you create, you can make some transformation. If I click on this line, it's just an independent line, I can click on my line and I can drag and move. If I just click on this line, I can also search one of these points, one of the corner points, and create some transformation, some modification, as you can see. So the aim is to use these different tools. You can also create a spline, and you can make multiple things like this. And after that, I can press right click and validate with enter, or you can press enter, enter, and validate the spline. So you have different tools like this. After to add these different tools, you will have also some transformation tools and transformation tools on the right. If, for example, I want to copy my element, I can use move copy. I need to select the object because you have a command line on this area and just drag and move here. Select, press enter and select a reference point and drag and move and create a copy. I could continue also if I want. You can have also more options tool. You can add B-fillet, you can add chamfer, you can add more. Even if I wanted to open my line, I can use one of these tools like brick vectors. I can click on a line, select like first point, like this point here, select a second point, this point here, and I can open. So definitely it is a very ergonomic tools, very interesting. After that, the aim, you can also edit some parameters. And after that, you will have a plot style manager and you have also a page setup. If I just go on file, you can find a plot style manager. Here we can keep these parameters. And if you go on file, you can find a plot preview. And you need first to select a page, to select a model of page, and after you will be able to activate a plot. When you click here, by default it is the models, but you can work on various layouts and you can also directly start from a specific layout. So this is the type of things that you will be able to do. I'm going to select this one and just press delete. So after that, when you will create your drawing, you have multiple options. You can go on file and you can find plot. You can define the size that you want. For example, you can also apply plot area. It can be a display, but it can be a window. You can create your own window and after you will be able to fit to paper or not. And each time when you just activate a preview, so file, you just click on plot preview, you will be able to see the render. So here I didn't make any adjustments. The aim is just to show you some basic and to show you that after you will be able to have a render of your element and then to print your work. You can also add text. You have text options. You can also add dimensions. So you have different dimension tools. So you can definitely do a lot of things. If I want to scale my element, I can click on the scale tools. Select, for example, all the objects and press enter, select a base point like this one. And after, in my command line, I can apply a value of 2, double click, and I can extend by 2 this element. So definitely it is very ergonomic tools. For a CAD software, free software, you have everything that you need. You have layers, you have properties, you have just drawing tools, you have also all the transformation tools, you have a command line, you can introduce your work on page. Definitely it's very convenient. So let's stop for this video. If you like, subscribe to this YouTube channel. First link on the description, the complete course. Nanocad version 5 is available. This is a free version of Nanocad. It is an older version, but you can work with 2D drawing for CAD. It is perfect. It is a very convenient tool, very interesting to have something complete for CAD. In this complete course, first link on the description, you will learn everything. All the different tools are explained one after one. I explain also everything about the layers, the dimension, introduce your work on a page. There are also exercises at the end, so you can create 2D drawing, you can create drawing for architectures, floor plan, all these type of things with this software. Second link on the description, the website is available, so you have a series of video tutorials on this on these channels, and each time when you see a video tutorial, you have a complete course at the end on link on the description. And for the next one, see you. Ciao, ciao.